Hello students, I am Gnaneshwara TN. In the previous session, I had introduced you the short story Living or Dead and its writer, Nobel laureate Indian poet Rabindranath Tagore. I hope you have read the story. In this session, let us discuss the main events of the story. The learning objective of this session is to help you to comprehend the story. After watching this video, you will know the meanings of difficult words, you will enjoy the story, you will understand the story, and you will develop listening skills. Let us recall what we have learnt in the previous session. Rabindranath Tagore was a Bengali poet, short story writer, and novelist. He was the first Bengali writer to elevate the short story to a serious art form. Tagore gives priority to women in his stories, later children, and lost men. The short story Living or Dead is a psychological story. It is a supernatural tale and an ironic parable. Now let me tell you the meanings of some difficult words. Abominably means unfairly. Apparition means a ghost or ghost-like image of a person. Forlorn means pitifully sad and abandoned or lonely. Incessant means continuing without pause or interruption. Maya means illusory affection binding a soul to the world. ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ತತ್ವಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಯೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವೋ ಅದು. ಸ್ಕಾಫ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಫ್ ಅಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್. ಸ್ಲಗಿಶ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್. ಸ್ನ್ಯಾಪ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ವಿಕ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇರಿಟೇಬ್ಲಿ. ಶ್ರಾವಣ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಶ್ರಾವಣ, ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಮಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲೆಂಡರ್. Thwarted means disappointingly unsuccessful. Torrent means a strong and fast moving stream of water. Upbraid means scold. Wail means make a prolonged high pitched sound. Waste means of a person become progressively weaker. Wit means a very small amount. Zenana means the part of a house for the seclusion of women. Now let me tell you the story in brief. Kadambini, the protagonist of the story, is a widow. She neither has a child. The child of her brother-in-law Sharda Shankar is her darling. She has fostered him because his mother has been very ill for a long time. One night Kadambini dies suddenly. Four of the zamindar's Brahmin servants take her body to the burning ground for cremation. In the absence of Brahmin servants, Kadambini awakens alone. She had not in fact died, but had only been temporarily unconscious. Seeing the cremation ground around her in the dead of the night, she believes that she has died and that she is now a ghost. She does not know where to go. To return to her father-in-law's house would be absurd, and she had no father's house. Then she remembered the friend of her childhood. Her friend Jogmaya is now married. When Kadambini arrives, Jogmaya is overjoyed. But after a period of time, Jogmaya gets fed up with Kadambini's presence and demands to know why her husband has not questioned Kadambini living in their house. So the husband embarks on a journey to Kadambini's family house to find out why she isn't living there. What he finds out is that Kadambini in fact died. Jogmaya doesn't believe it, but late at night, while the two are quarreling about the matter, Kadambini comes to confirm that she did indeed die. Then Kadambini left her friend's house and returns to her in-laws' home. When she holds her beloved nephew, the sick child, she realizes that she is not a ghost. She tries to convey the fact to the family members, but they are not in a position to believe her words. Finally, she throws herself into a well in the courtyard and dies there. It's only by dying that she was able to prove that she was alive. Let us recapitulate what we have learned in this session. Kadambini, the widow, has no child. She has fostered her brother-in-law's son, whose mother has been ill for a long time. One day, she dies suddenly. Four Brahmin servants take her body to the burning ground for cremation. In the absence of Brahmin servants, Kadambini awakens alone. Believing that she is a ghost, she is not in a position to go to her own house. So, she goes to the house of her childhood friend Jogmaya. Her friend is overjoyed seeing the old friend, but after a month, she gets fed up with Kadambini's presence in her house. Then Kadambini returns to her in-law's house and realizes that she is not dead after seeing her beloved child. She tries to convey the truth to the family members, but they are not in a position to believe her words. She throws herself into a well and proves that she was not dead by dying. This is the irony. Now, let me check your understanding. I will ask some multiple choice questions. Try to answer them. Question number one. The place where Kadambini lives with her in-laws is option A, Nisindapur, option B, Ranihat, option C, Durgahat, option D, Mohinihat. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option B, Ranihat. Question number two. Kadambini had option A, husband, option B, a son, option C, both husband and a son, option D, neither husband nor a son. Yes, you are correct. The correct option is option D, neither husband nor a son. Question number 3. Jogmaya is Kadambini's option A, sister, option B, sister-in-law, option C, childhood friend, option D, aunt. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option C, childhood friend. Question number 4. Kadambini plunges herself into a dash. Option A, sea, option B, well, option C, river, option D, stream. Yes, you are correct. The correct answer is option B, well. Question number 5. Kadambini proves that she was not dead. Option A, by dying. Option B, by arguing. Option C, by quarreling. Option D, by leaving home. Yes, you are correct. The correct option is option A, by dying. This is the list of websites and books I referred. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.